We are going to proceed this how it is moving. This is for the Bagisu. Then after we'll look at that one of the Ratiga, okay? Then we start identifying the different aspects we have seen within these different cultures. Are we together?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so Najida, you can play that video. Hope it is clear.
Yes, kinda.
Okay, so
master,
what are they doing?
But this is culture,
teacher,
this is culture.
Teacher,
yes.
The thing is so weird, yes. Bad looking, even my appetite has gone.
Teacher, can't you go
eating,
to a hospital?
Yes.
Can't you go to a hospital?
Okay, so now those are the discussions I want. That's why you have seen the video. That's why you put that video there. So that we can see and look at the discussion. What's the issues behind them doing that?
To be sure,
okay, so that's what we're going to study. Whether
my
we like it or
thing
not,
is out.
This is what we're going to study.
Okay.
So,
the thing is out, it's red. But nice.
Okay, so are we there?
Yes,
so are we there
yes.
Now? Okay.
Yes,
so
yes.
I'm going to talk about the Bagisu. Okay. Remember last time we had about the Sabines, not so?
Yes.
So for the Sabines, you remember, I don't know who was explaining to us. Chemtai told us about his culture, about her culture, and then there was also those ones from Queen. Are you getting it? There are two. For them, in their culture, they circumcise boys. Okay? In Queen, they circumcise girls. Then you see that circumcision taking place. That's how they do it also, the other side, to the girl's side. Okay?
But how?
So, how?
Yes.
You also want us to play that one of how you'll not run away.
No, as in how do they circumcise the girls?
How do they circumcise the girls?
Yeah, what do they circumcise? There are some...
You'll ask your biology teachers.
No.
There is any way that...
No, we have to ask our history teachers.
I don't know the biological term. I don't know the biological term, but it's better when you get it in the biological term.
No, master,
Where is Chemtai?
I can.
Rita is around. Rita, what do they circumcise?
Yes.
They cut.
What do they circumcise from the
Okay,
girls?
I'm not sure. I've never asked those things because it's really scary.
Master.
Very scared.
I've never really seen them because I...
Master.
Mm.
Me, yes. I know. But it's so weird to talk. I know, but it's so weird to talk.
Don't you see? They are better in biological terms. Didn't mean you know them, but this Uganda word is too big.
Yeah, then Master, you tell us.
The Uganda
so
word
small.
Is big.
You tell us.
Suppose you are supposed to be in senior three. Suppose you are supposed to be in senior three next year.
Master.
Yes.
They circumcise the sausage.
It's okay. You don't need to.
Hey. Those ones, Nagenda saying it's okay. So anyway,
don't need to say over.
I say. Now when it comes to the Bagistu, okay, because that is that culture, you have seen that people around, okay. One, you have to go through, it is like a drive. Okay, it's like a fundraising drive. You go through dancing, you can even do it for a full week. When you are notifying people that I'm going to be circumcised next week, I'm getting it. All of this week from Monday, you go through dancing, enjoying everything. Better than people be collecting money. Okay, people be collecting money for you. They'll be awarding you things, gifts, what and what, etc. The only good thing about it, when you are grown up, it's you to decide on which person is going to circumcise you. You decide as a person. That this one is going to circumcise me and they are fine with it. You pick the person who's going to circumcise you. But it is done in open. It is done in open and everyone is... what is taking place. That's why you see those videos
Excuse
are being
me,
recorded.
Teacher.
They even take pics. Yes?
Excuse me, teacher. What if you're shy and then you don't like to be circumcised in public?
Then you are not a man. You are not a man. That's why they wait for them to grow up. They don't. This circumcision now what they are doing nowadays. That when you go to the moment they give birth to you, 1 week, 2 weeks, they circumcise you in the hospital. That one is not. It's not part of that. Region in the religious part of it, okay, the culture part of it, you are not circumcised like that. In their culture, if a boy is circumcised at the age of 10 or 12, are you getting it? And there is a man who is 45 years of age, but is not circumcised. That man is not supposed to sit in the elders' meeting, but this boy of 12 sits in the elders' meeting. Because for them, the moment they circumcise you, that's when you become a man.
Okay.
Are you getting it? The moment you go through their culture circumcision, their practice, that's when you become a man.
Okay.
And it's even upon the ladies. You get married to the lady, and that lady gets to know that you are not circumcised. She can run away because you are not a man to be with her because you are not circumcised. You can't take decisions. That's their culture. The woman will take the, will even beat you from the house because you are young. You are still a boy. You are in the teenage age. Even if you are 50, you are young. Till when you are circumcised, that's when you can start taking orders in the family as a man. And that's the, those are the Bagishu. That's their culture. You are supposed to go stand. Me, I witnessed it also. I witnessed it live. I was in Imbale during my university studies. I waited for that time because I wanted to see, is it true? You know, sometimes we speak about culture and they're like myth. Yeah? It's like a myth, something which is just imaginary. Are you getting it? But that boy dances up to the area where they're going to circumcise him from when he dances. But anyway, it is quick. Within 30 seconds, they have already finished the circumcision part of it. The guys are too fast and they're accurate. Okay, they have those, they have their knives, they are too sharp.
Tested.
So, yes?
They said that if they cut you slowly, that if you feel pain and you get scared and cry, it's a sin. So they cut very fast so that you don't feel pain and you just don't get scared and run away when they're still cutting.
No, by the way, even if you, when you cry or when you shake or when this kind of shivering, when they're going to cut you and they say, what is wrong with this one? You're supposed to be strong. That's why in most cases, they used to hold, sometimes they used to hold a stick. You hold the stick in both your arms and raise it up. Are you getting it? To show that you are strong. The moment it comes down, you are a coward. The moment you come down, you are a coward. So those are the Bagishu. That's their culture. To be a man, you are supposed to be circumcised publicly. People have to see. And after circumcision, that's why you've seen these people when they are dancing. They don't carry you back home. They drum and you start dancing there and then. They put the medicine there and then and you dance. To show that you're a man, you are strong enough. Yeah. I'm getting it. There is nothing like I'm feeling pain. So that is culture. Okay? So that is culture. So that's how things move on. And that's life. That's how life is. Okay? So those are the Bagishu. And that's the same way the Sabines also do their circumcision. It's not supposed to be a hospital circumcision. Okay? It's not supposed to be a hospital circumcision. It's supposed to be a public circumcision. And sometimes people even decide on what they're going to use when they're circumcising them. After circumcision, that's why some people use paper. You know, red paper? The kamulari.
Yeah,
they put kamulari there, or there are some local herbs they put. So that they make everything look fine and move on. So that is it. Unless you have any question about the Bagishu now.
Done. You want breakfast?
To do what?
Rita, you want breakfast? You're
not blessed. My screen, you want?
Rita, you want to eat from class? Rita, you want to eat from class?
No.
Hey, but you don't want breakfast. You want, but you are standing away. Okay. You they care about you. People here that first get off Zoom, they can prepare their breakfast. Like that Babirie. That Babirie Mariam. There is this Babura and Abigaba. Those are that to first finish study, you can prepare breakfast for yourself. So you'll be there. You are the big sister.
How do
you? So you have to go and prepare for the young ones.
How do you know about
our? I know some of you will. Some of you will just see you and will know what happens. Okay, so that's the about the Bagis too. Their king is called Omukuka. They prepare for themselves. They are good meals, the way we talked about them. They eat bamboo, but when it's still in the infant stages, when it's not so hard, when they get the bamboo, they pound it, they sun dry it, and they put it in gignuts. So in Buganda, this side you put in gignuts, you put their mushrooms. Okay, for them they put there that bamboo, and it is sweet. Though sometimes it takes a lot of time to get ready. Have you ever tasted it? But you have to cut it, then you have to soak it in water for some good time. Like 2 hours or 3 hours, we put it in the gignuts. So that's how they move on.
Thank you, Enoch. Thank you so much.
So, you see now this sham sambu, when you don't want to cook, the whole family becomes hungry.
Good morning.
So that is it. Okay, that's about the Bagis too. Hope we still remember the other cultures. Hope we still remember the other cultures of last week. Okay.
Yes.
No stepping.
Okay, so I'm going to talk about the. I don't know. There is. Some people from the north, we talked about, I think, were they the Aru, the Aru people? There is one of the culture in the north whereby for them, the ladies can even work for the family. The ladies work for the family. If the husband is non-performing, they make you stay there, stay home, sit, and they go work and bring money home. Okay, and for them it is okay, and they enjoy. Okay, so that is their life. Okay, if not, you have to make sure that you work to the fullest and feed the people who are home. If you can't, they chase you away. A woman can chase you away, and they do whatever they want. Najinda.
Yes, teacher.
You can go back. We can go and play the other next video about the Bachiga. We never looked at the Bachiga.
I'm a tourist guide, a female tourist guide and safari guide. Bachiga is such a unique tribe. It's a strong niche for Uganda, the Bachiga. As Bachiga, they are very, very, very hospitable. That's number one. They are very friendly. They are very strong. When you look at our land tail line, you know, strengthens our muscles. Then our culture is so unique. For example, the landscape has created us to be very strong and very friendly and energetic. That energy is kind of like contagious. When you come to Kabare, you feel like you want to stay. Then the terraces, when you look at Lake Bunyonyi, it has like four combinations of the beauty, what makes it stand. We produce a lot of food. We are known. You know, when you are coming from Kampala and you are coming down Kigezi, they will say, you are going to Kabare, okay. There are two things they always mention. Number one, emondi. Those are Irish potatoes. And sorghum, which makes the bushera.
This is a true Muchiga lady. This is a true Muchiga lady. She's going to have, the basket defines us. The basket you see here. And our energy. Our energy. You know how she's balancing? We have a special thing where almost my clients, how do you balance this thing? Someone's like, how do you, I just said, should I show you? I can balance it. the music of Bachiga. It is recorded in the whole history of the world. We do the most strongest dance you ever find. That energy I talked about, the hills have made us so physical that our dance is so contagious that even when you don't know the dance, when they begin the drum, they start stamping down the feet, you forget even that you don't know how to dance. You find yourself on the floor dancing. So the dance and the music are very special to Kigezo area. We are so lucky that I can even talk about the western region, the southwestern part of Uganda. We have like 60% of the attractions of the country. So the unique part of Kigezi is, for example, when you're in Kabare town, you drive 2 hours to Volcanic Mountain, 2 hours to Kigali, 2 hours to Kisoro, which is Congo, 1 hour to the Mountain Gorilla, 3 hours to Lake Mburu, 3 hours to Queen Elizabeth National Park. So that this is a link because we have mountain gorillas as the niche, the strong niche for everyone to come and see. Must take Kabare as a relaxing point and looking at Runyonyi.
Okay, so we have heard about the Bachiga. Okay.
Yes.
You find about the Bachiga. How many Bachigas are here? I name Babas. You seem to be a Muchiga.
Me.
Even me.
No, I'm not
Babra.
A Muchiga.
Babra, you're a Muchiga.
Yes.
Zawede, you're not a Muchiga. No. That is not the Chiga name.
I tell by man.
But Bachigas, raise up your hand. Man is a don't deceive you. My man is a Mukonjo from these people who crossed from Congo, the Bantu migration, who came from the Congo Katanga Basin. You remember them? So those ones are the ones who those that is Mr. Bayman. He's not a he can't dance that Chichiga. You see, have you ever seen him with that energy? Eh? He can't be that energy. That energy is only for the Bachiga people. The Misty Anakagwa, that name is not Chichiga. The Agatha can be there, but now Luvega, is a way they know. Let me look for the Bachiga people. You know, no. Asimwe has to be a Muchiga. Who else? Let me see. Nyakato.
I didn't know Bachiga. I didn't know people admire our tribe.
I'm not a Chiga. I think they want to ask questions.
Hey, okay. So I want to people tell us what happens to your side, but you are running away. So anyway, for the Bachiga.
Teacher, what about Baganda?
I'm with him.
Baganda.
Baganda.
That is known by everyone.
Barbara, keep quiet. Don't start. I know.
So, they're even enjoying our Wi-Fi. Their network and their place is bad.
And they're decent.
You know, our hospital, we can check all of you out.
Yes, we can.
No.
Barbara, keep quiet.
Yes.
Barbara, make sure they don't test you.
Things
are not easy. People may run away and you are nowhere to be seen. Anyway, so we have been talking about the Bachiga. Okay. The video you've seen was about the Bachiga. Not so.
Yes.
Though I know Baba has denied to be a Muchiga and the same way. But it is
that's
fine.
I'm not denying. That's the fact. I'm not a Muchiga.
I know, but you are from where?
Even the accent says it.
I am a Munyankole.
You are a Munyankole?
Right. Maybe she's
the Bachiga. Mixed breed, eh?
Then,
no.
Okay, so.
Maybe.
Okay. So we are talking about, we have been to, I want to talk about the Bachiga Nation, eh? Nowadays, by the way, they are proud of themselves. I don't know why people here are denying and running away from them, but the tribe I know which is proud of themselves from that side are the Bachiga. Even if you call them Chiga Mnyankole, she will quarrel and say, no, I am not. Miamu Mchiga, what and what? Reason, they are proud of who they are. So you've seen the areas around, the areas they talked about, okay? Lake Bunyonyi, Lake Mburo, you have the Gorilla Park. It's easy to move to Rwanda. Those two short distances amongst them. Those have ever happened to move to Kabale, when you're going to Kabale, or those have ever used that the road transport to move to Rwanda, their terrace is good looking, it is nice, it is adventure as you are moving, but it is scary. Okay? But it is scary. That one I assure you. Because you move on the road, you see where you are going, you are up, you are sloping down, but you see where you are going. From this side,
teacher,
yes.
When my mom was having a workshop, she decided to take me, and they were going to work in Western Uganda, so I would have a chance to meet my grandmother and family. So we were going to Kabale, and the road is so small. It's on a hill. It's like as if the car is going to fall down, and the road is too small. You can see down. Everything that is down. It's like as if you're going to fall down the road.
That's what makes it adventurous when you're going to Kabale. The road is small, but it is adventurous because people enjoy. Okay, people enjoy.
I have a question. Is it a place hilly? Is Kabale hilly or anything like that? Is the place hilly?
Is hilly. Very hilly.
Very, very hilly.
Very cold. Okay.
Because that's why when you are passing through those routes, sometimes you are even passing through the mountains. They just start to break through a mountain and create a road to connect to somewhere else. In Kabale, there is a route which they used to use now that time back. It was the only main route. But when you are not a driver from that side, they never used to allow people to drive from there. Are you getting it? They never used to allow people to drive from there. They tell you, I'm from this side, you know, they tell you, okay, get out of the car. Then somebody who is an expert in those areas drives you up to the end or up to the top, then you can slope. Because of the fear, you can easily make an accident, yeah? Because you look this side, you are going to fall. You look the other side, you are going to fall. So only the eligible people are the only ones who are supposed to be riding that side. So that is Kabale. Anyway, it is nice, but teacher, it is cold.
Teacher.
Yes?
Teacher. The roads, you're not, okay, like, yes, you're not supposed to overtake a vehicle. You're not supposed to overtake a vehicle, or else you'll get an accident.
Uh-huh. They're like those roads of Kaptura.
Overtake. You cannot even overtake.
They're like those of Kaptura. Those ones who know Kaptura, Rita may know Kaptura very well. Now, like those roads of Kaptura, you can't overtake from them because there are corners everywhere and they are small. You are supposed to drive at a given speed.
And even the double bends.
Everyone will be fine. So that's how the things be, okay? So this Uthman, who is from Korea, you'll tell us how your Korean things work. So the only thing I like about the Bachiga is because of their food, the Irish potatoes. I like them. It's my best food.
Even
I can prepare it anytime potatoes. I want.
Even us, we have Irish potatoes.
But you... Yours are not as hard as those ones of Kabale.
Also have Irish potatoes.
Yours are soft. Yours are soft. They can easily make porridge when you overcook them. But the ones of Kavale, when you ever cook them, they are hard. Those had bit of Irish potatoes, yeah? So for them, that's their main activity. Irish, in the moment, yeah. That's why I've heard people talking about that Irish potato, and they ask, is it from Kavale? Eh? When they're buying Irish potato. Is it the Kavale product or what? So because they know those Bachiga produce the Irish potatoes more than anything else.
Teacher, you can tell an Irish potato. You can tell an Irish potato from Kavale and then that's not from Kavale.
And the one of Kavale has that reddish cover. That reddish bit
and
of it.
It's very hard. It's like a...
It's still
and it is and hard. It's hard like the people who do the farming. Or why they overstep on them when they are jumping. I don't know. So... And that is Kavale, okay? So that is Kavale and those are the Bachiga. You have seen their dance. If you can't jump over 1 meter high, you are not a Muchiga. You are supposed to jump 1 meter when you are dancing, come back and step. You have to use energy, whatever things, everything they do, they use energy because that's how they're formulated. They're energetic people. Even when they are speaking, they speak with authority. Wait. Yeah, me, I'm from Kavale. What do you want to do? Eh? Would you manage? Eh? They threaten you, eh?
Teacher, and if you look at most people from there, when they are stepping down, you hear the sound that this one has stepped down. I have a cousin,
that's
and whenever she's walking, you can hear her footsteps from afar.
Not really. I have a neighbor in class. She's a Muchiga, but everything is normal.
There they have energy.
It's because this one has grown almost all her life in the village.
Maybe.
You see, there are those improved Bachigas, yeah? There are these improved Bachigas of nowadays. Those ones who only go back to their homes when they are going back to Bari and on Christmas Day. We're not talking about those ones. We're talking about the Bachiga, like we see now, like the girl we see Chemtai right now is in Sebei. Chemtai is in the homeland. Those are the typical Bachigas you are talking of. But you Bachigas of nowadays, you want to be home, you want to be in Kampala, you go back for Christmas and come back on fast. Eh? That's why you see them, they are soft, eh? When you find a soft Muchiga, just know that soft Muchiga is the... It's not from Kavale. It's not the origin.
It's not from me. We are strong.
So, you are strong.
Yes.
It's like finding a new. It's like finding a
Mtoro. Not all.
It's like finding a Mtoro who is also hard. Yeah? Who is too strong and is bold. That one is also rare. But Toros are supposed to be
so. Not so rare.
But Toros have to be soft. They speak Empako Yawe, Amoti, Akiki, Yemawe. They can speak a sentence for almost 20 minutes. They want to say, I'm going to the market. They'll say, Amoti, me, I'm going. Yeah. Just to the market. They speak slowly.
No.
They don't. and that's how they are, okay? Those are the Vatoros. And they enjoy. That's their life, okay? They enjoy. So that's how they be. We are talking about culture. So those are the Vatoros. Somebody asking me about just that some people in the chat room, they have started making their chibozi there. They even dragged away the messages. Nuriat, why do you want to leave us, to leave you alone? We are telling you the truth about your Batoros. And now when Mtoro invites you for a wedding, eh, when they tell you 4 p.m., go at 7, because the bride and the groom can march from the cars to the venue for almost 1 hour. Because the road is slow until they increase on the they reduce on the speed when they're going for those occasions. So they become too slow. And that is life. So you just have to be ready and move with them. Okay? So that's the... And just for them, and that's how things have to move, on. So after there, we've looked at those two. Someone wanted to tell us about the Banyoro, but I don't know if he's still there to tell us about the Nyoro tribe. If he's not there, then we can proceed to something else. Having a Munyoro there. Someone last year came and said, "Teacher, I passed the Banyoro. You have not told us. Eh? You have not even picked us. Now me are looking for the Banyoro. They are hiding." Or you have feared the culture because you have talked about the culture of the Bagisu. Now you are
teacher,
feared.
There are no Banyoro.
Teacher, me, I'm here.
Hey, someone has come. So,
but her network.
Okay, so tell us. Huh. Banyoro, what's wrong with your network? Are you home?
Very poor.
In Kampala? Are you home?
Teacher, I'm here.
Okay. Tell us about the Nyoro tribe now.
She doesn't.
What? It's a really lovely tribe.
Just lovely, no, like that. Know. Even ask you are lovely. Hey.
No, I mean, its culture is also unique in a way. It's very historical. Mm-hmm. And we are very soft spoken. Yeah.
Mm. You accept whatever comes.
No.
Hmm?
We don't just
you accept whatever comes. You don't accept me.
No.
Hmm. Uh-huh.
The language that you speak is almost like the Lutoro.
Not almost, it is Lutoro, yes. Because you are the
traditional
same.
Weddings.
Yeah.
We wear traditional wear called Kitambi.
Okay. So you are also the ones who prepare offers with meat. And so you mix offers with meat.
Excuse me, teacher, I didn't.
When you are preparing toast, you mix offers with meat.
Yes, but
when you are preparing.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
This one. Oh.
Yes, teacher.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we also roast meat. Hello?
Now we're hearing.
We roast meat, boil it in mushrooms, and eat it with millet bread.
Okay. The Batoros are the ones with the Batoros and the Banyoro are the same.
Yeah, okay.
I'm seeing Chigundu's hand is up. Chigundu, what is it? Abdurrahman.
No.
You don't want him to speak about the Banyoro?
Children, instead of studying, chatting.
Okay, so Aisha. You mean they are done? The about the Banyoro tribe, it is done.
No, you can ask for more references. Me, that's where my memory stops.
That's why your memory stops. That's why your memory stops, eh?
Yes.
So those ones who are in the chat room, we're talking about your funny things, eh? You better. Better stop. Okay, so we have got to know about the Banyoro, a little bit of them, and what belongs to them. So after there, so that is the Chitambi people put on in the Banyoro. So I think the best dance we have in Uganda is that of the Sogi and that of the Baganda, the traditional dances. Yes. The Sogi and the Baganda.
Even Gishu.
They have the best dance.
What about the Lakaraka? Even Banyoro. Lakaraka, teacher.
Mama, Lakaraka. Hey, Lakaraka is also nice.
Teacher, even
it's
our
also
dance
good.
Is good.
The Lakaraka dance.
Yes.
Which dance? Soft dance.
Runyege.
The soft dance. The soft dance you'll be having.
Hip break
that
dance.
One is known. It's known.
Yeah, you're bullying us.
The only dance? Dance is supposed to be for people to enjoy. But if at all people cannot enjoy, we have no option. Okay? We have no option but to we just see and we move on. So after there, we move to another aspect. Okay? And those people who are there. Hey, by the way, I forgot. Kayura.
Kayura. Yes,
Mpako yawe?
Akiki.
Anuri at Mpako yawe?
Is that their pet name? Aboli.
Hey, that's Aboli, eh?
Yes.
Mpako yange Adieri.
Akiki.
Nyamu Adieri.
Tichayamu.
Nyamu Adieri.
Tichayamu Nyoro.
Tichayamu Nyoro.
My girlfriend was a Munyoro. Like the Bachiga.
Just because she left you doesn't mean that
you continue with her name.
What is the culture for the present?
Excuse me, teacher, I have a question.
Yes, Kayura.
Teacher, you say your pet name is Adieri. What's the meaning of Adieri?
I said, do I know?
Nice question.
My language, DL means cow. So I guess it means a cow or something.
That means a cow.
DL means cow.
That is not true, Nyoro. That's not true, Nyoro.
But where?
Oh, when you don't know, I didn't mean a cow.
From which place? Tell me.
Adiel is a street
I said
name.
DL. I didn't say Adieli. I said DL, so. Where are they derived from? If you find out where they're from, then you'll understand.
So, anyway, Hannah, come and tell me what my pet name means. And Nuriat, tell me what my pet name means. Hurry up before I forget.
Teacher, your pet name means bride or bridegroom, from my knowledge.
Hey, so which means soon. soon I'm becoming Najinda prepare.
Husband.
Prepare your grammar stick.
No.
Prepare your grammar stick to. And Najinda is preparing the grammar stick to escort me.
Najinda, I'm your plus one.
Oh, to escort you. Okay.
Hey, you thought what? I'm going back looking for those ones in Bachiga. I have to get those Bachigas who are strong.
They'll beat you. Okay. They'll beat you.
No, I'm going to go first. I'm going first to Ahidi. You know me, I'm always first to Ahidi, eh? No,
I'm
Korean.
Talk of that. You're a Musoga.
So who is the Musoga? Who is the Musoga here? Tell us about the Basoga tribe.
Me. Hola.
Me, teacher.
Who?
Miracle.
Me.
Who?
Soon.
Judith.
Me.
Please.
My name? Me.
Judith or my son?
Yes,
Mukoda is his name. Is his forgotten name? Remember?
Sorry, I'm not a sogi. I'm not gi.
Mukoda, tell us.
Paula, why? Why you denying your tribe?
Yes, don't deny your tribe.
Is it a sogi or what? I don't have tribe.
Yes.
What are your sogi?
What are your sogi? Garrison is a sogi.
Paula, tell us about the Basoga.
Is something wrong with our network?
What do you mean?
Let me tell.
The network is wrong with is within the Basoga.
Yes, please.
You're just asking. You know that River Nile belongs to Buganda, eh? It's not in Basoga, eh? River Nile belongs to Uganda, so Basoga starts after River Nile,
yes.
Eh?
Yes.
So Basoga think that they have the Nile.
Oh, the Nile starts from us.
And let's
the Nile just separates Basoga and Buganda. Okay, so tell us about Basoga. Okay, so tell us about Basoga.
I tell you about Musoga.
If you can't already giving us Najinda has already gone to the chat room to tell us everything.
You don't know a lot about, actually I know nothing. I just know they also wear Gomez's.
You also wear Gomez, is that you come from Buganda?
Teacher, someone is asking if a pet name is a surname.
There's a different way in which they tie their Chitambala thingy, but then they don't even tie it, they just fold it.
Let it be that the river now belongs to you.
Okay, so Mokola, I don't even know about your culture.
So I know about my culture.
She can't even speak the language, teacher.
Can you
speak your language?
Yes.
First, think of yourself before you think of.
Ola, no hard feelings.
Me, I can speak mine. Let me see.
Natchitende.
Natchitende there.
Yes, she's
Natchitende.
There.
How are you, Natchitende? Natchitende, how are you? I want you to speak.
There's
no.
What way
some
the
people
connection?
Fear to speak. Some people fear to speak.
But why?
They fear the microphone. Okay, so anyway, when we look at those different activities, let me see, Nathan, Najinda, go back to our NCDC book and look at that history book of NCDC. Go back to that NCDC book.
Okay, is this eternal thing?
For the study material.
We go to the home study. Look on home study.
Is this the channel D?
Who is asking me?
Judith.
Judith, you are in the village. You don't even have network. Nakanya doesn't have network. Yeah.
Yeah, teacher, imagine
that,
if the parents were there.
Nakajago, you don't have network.
Yeah, what if the parents are there seated next to her?
Listening to you.
And to hear that Nakajako is a Muya, who doesn't? No, in senior one knows. She's stubborn. Yes, teacher.
Teacher, I was very stubborn.
Either the mother should even be around.
Hello?
So, Mason, move to... Mason, move to culture. Move to culture. Scroll to culture. Scroll to culture.
Culture.
Okay. Move down.
I continue.
Now from there, first up there.
Okay.
So when we zoom that in, we'll look at culture. Okay. So in culture, they have told us about the attitudes, our beliefs, what we believe in our cultures. Okay. Baganda have their demigods, the Dungu, the Juju of theirs, what and what, the bewitching. And almost all cultures have that kind of. All those cultures have those things of juju, witch doctors.
No.
Cultures we know.
We do not have witch doctors.
Even the Indians believe in their cow. That's why India they don't eat cow. They don't eat beef. In India they don't eat beef.
They're so
eating God.
Okay.
So this one was...
Yes, teacher, not all.
This Abdurang man is an Indian and he enjoys meat more than anything else. He's not an Indian. He's just pretending. Because when they bring meat, you run to the forest. Okay, so from there, we have the language, okay? We have the customs, the norms and the customs.
Yes.
What people do, those ones, their day-to-day activities within the culture. I get it. Then we have the rituals,
yes.
Okay? Whereby you're not supposed to break that ritual. When you break it, you become a sinner. Or sometimes
eating
they even chase
chicken.
You away.
Eating
okay, like
eggs.
Ladies in Buganda are not supposed to eat chicken. They're not supposed to eat eggs.
Why? Teacher,
okay.
Why?
No, those are rituals. Those are rituals. Okay.
Excuse me, teacher.
Yes?
It means that men are greedy.
You buy your chicken, the wife prepares the chicken very well, then you buy for her beans or guinats to eat.
Teacher, that's greediness. How can you let me cook the chicken and I don't eat anything?
Segregation.
Yes.
Teacher, that is segregation.
At home, the father enjoys the chicken with the son. The daughters only enjoy ginnat.
Okay. Those were in those days.
I
now we rule.
Teacher, wow. I wish I was a boy. I wish I was a boy.
You wish.
Now, who said that?
Okay. Okay. So, okay, so from there.
Okay, it's good that you're born in the modern days.
Yes.
Silence. So from there, we go to behavior. Okay. The behavior part of it, how people behave in their, how do they relate with their neighbors? Some cultures are friendly, some cultures are unfriendly. Some cultures never wanted to marry from each other because of the hatred they had amongst each other, like the Baganda and the Banyoro. They never used to be friends, so they had to get married there. Yeah. Then you have the faith and religion.
Now they're still enemies.
Up to now, they're still enemies, eh? But nowadays, you can go to Bunyora and get a so lady from there.
We are still enemies.
Yeah, we're not enemies.
Teacher.
Okay, so from there, we have food, which people enjoy most, and people prepare their foods differently, okay? Like when you heard about the Banyoro. By the way, I went to Kagadi, my first time. When I went to Kagadi some years back, I think I was at university, like in 2011, I think. I don't start calculating my years, and knowing that I'm old, don't start calculating these years. Yeah. You are starting getting pens and calculators. So,
someone is my son going to wear that Gomez?
So when I went to Kagadi, they prepared the food. It was nice. I reached sauce and I didn't taste. I found sauce meat mixed with the offals, and they prepare them. They serve them at once. They add. I was like, no. I threw for something else to eat. I get it because I was not used to eat. So that's the step of food. You go to Bugisu, they'll give you the Malewa. You go to the West, they'll give you the Shabwe. Eh? I ate Shabwe and it made my stomach worse. I had to be near the toilet every time after eating it. So that's why nowadays I go when you don't have chicken, I don't eat. Eh? But that is what I enjoy. So there is that art and drama, folk music, okay, the dances, the architecture they do. The so-called molding, people do crafts, are you getting it? That's why every culture has its own drum. Every culture has its own drum. The Bagisu have that Kalung drum, they sound, the Basoga, the Basoga and the Baganda have almost the same drums. The Bachiga have the drum, they sound when they're dancing, their Chiga dance. When you go to those people in the north, those ones who do Rakaraka, eh? The Rakaraka. Yeah. They also do, they have their things they do, they drum, eh? And they're nice, okay? They enjoy. Some cultures are represented by their pots they put on. Are you getting it? Among others. Yeah. Then you have what we call attitudes, okay? Attitudes is the way of behavior. I talked about the Bachiga being too rough, okay? They are rough and they are energetic. The Banyoro are soft-spoken and they are easy to... They're easy to let me say, to do what?
To
they're
cry.
Easy to lie. They're easy to lie, eh? Because they are too soft. They don't want to harm anyone. Okay?
Yes.
They don't want to harm anyone, the Banyoro. So they be like, okay, let me see. But mommy refused me from going out. They told me when you go out there, those people can eat people. But they don't want to harm you. They tell you in a polite way. I get it. They tell you the polite way. So that's how they be. So we have seen that about culture. I get it. We have seen that about culture. So that's what is embedded in culture. So whoever is telling us about your culture, some of you didn't tell us about some of those things which are there. Okay. So when you are looking at culture, we look at that in the bigger perspective of it. From there, Nadia, they can scroll and scroll downwards. You scroll Those ones are human values. Everyone can go there and read for themselves about that. Scroll down. Let's continue. Okay, so we are seeing those ones there. First, go back to that art for our the African art and values. We have seen people selling those sculptures in town.
Okay? Yeah.
Of those ladies like that. I'm getting it. You have seen those printings. Okay. Yeah. And those printings, people enjoy them. Okay. It's because sometimes it identifies. That identifies who they are and where they come from. So you'll find most of them putting those things in their sitting rooms because it is part of their culture. Sometimes they want to support the person who is doing it because that person is promoting their culture more than anything else. Yeah. This one on the right, Inga, is too big.
She's pregnant.
Okay, you can scroll. Scroll. I've not seen anything in that picture. Now, scroll. That one is just the map of Uganda, showing us the different cultures we have and the different districts, okay, and the kingdoms where they are located. Okay, so activity. We stop there. On the activity of culture at family level, okay? So, have you seen that activity?
Yes,
using a table, list four unacceptable and acceptable behaviors. Okay.
In your family.
In your family. Okay. Those ones which are within your family. What are those acceptable behaviors and what are those unacceptable behaviors? Are we there? Okay. So all of you will go to the Google. You'll go to the e-learning platform. You know how to enter there. You know the passwords.
Yes.
For Abdurrahman, I don't know who is your friend here. Who will send you those questions? Because Abdurrahman doesn't have the first word.
And those ones are CBC books.
Mm-hmm. You look at you have not made any friend,
teacher.
Okay, just take a screenshot. I'm going to give you a friend. I'm going to give you a friend here. Let me see. Farid, do you have a friend?
Inbox.
No, he does not.
But also, Farid doesn't
have a friend. My Sunda friend.
What?
Okay,
yes,
so
my sons are good friends.
I think you should give them passwords.
My son.
Najin, they're going
my
to be a friend to
friendly.
Farid.
Very friendly.
My son, you don't even talk.
What?
You leave my son to talk for herself. You leave my son to talk for herself.
My son is really nice. Let her be the friend.
You guys,
so
Tisha,
anyway, Farid,
not nice
Farid and,
to me.
Farid and Abdurrahman, choose. Abdurrahman, whom are you choosing? You just look at the name, which is good to you, and tell me this one.
My son.
Yes.
What's the page?
Let me check. 16.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome.
So, Abdurrahman, you have to. Whom are you choosing?
We are going to choose.
I'm still here. Abdurrahman, whom are you choosing? Who?
No, it's actually 10, not 9.
Okay. I was going to take a picture and send it on the NGS site for those who don't have. But.
Okay, Farid, I have Farid. Farid, you choose. Abdurrahman is in fear. Yes?
Abdurrahman.
What?
I'm not hearing. Farid, whom are you choosing?
the WhatsApp group.
You are threatening people.
I'm not on WhatsApp.
WhatsApp group.
You are threatening people. Yeah.
Really, me taking a screenshot and she's going to send a work on the WhatsApp group.
But I haven't found that page.
Okay.
My son scroll down and we see the page.
Najin, let's scroll down and we see the page. It is there. It is page 10. Page 10. You can take a screenshot and put it in the and load it in the WhatsApp group, eh?
We are not in the WhatsApp group.
So that's the activity. Those are not there. You'll be adding.
Excuse me,
yes,
sir.
Yes.
So I am neither in the WhatsApp group, neither on the e-learning platform.
And your phone is on WhatsApp or you don't have a phone?
It is on WhatsApp.
My network connection is
unavailable. It is on WhatsApp, right? Okay, so you send Mr. Namdala your WhatsApp number to add you there.
Yes,
teacher. You know him.
I only know Mr. Stenola because he's my uncle and the one who gave me the.
Well, I can give to Mr. Hey. Bang.
Yeah.
Then tell Mr. Stenola. Tell Mr. Stenola to add you on the group, on the senior one group, eh?
Okay.
Okay. And I'm going. Anyway, I will even talk to him. It is fine. Okay. But you haven't got a friend. Whom are you choosing?
Teacher, I've taken a screenshot.
You are choosing who?
Shamsa Uthman.
Shamsa Uthman, yeah?
Shamsa.
Yes.
Shamsa.
You have got a friend.
Mute our ears.
Okay, so others mute. All of you mute now. Let me mute all of you then. I'll come back to you when time is there. Okay. Then Farid. Farid.
Yes?
Farid, which friend are you choosing? Shamsa Uthman is taken.
Mr. Nurdin.
Yes.
There is someone in the list who is using just a dot. Can you help me and you remove that person from the class?
Let just me remove who?
That's those.
I have already removed.
Remove.
That one I've already removed.
Go away.
Okay, so Farid.
Yeah.
Farid, whom are you choosing?
Excuse me, teacher.
First way, Farid is choosing your friend.
Precious.
Farid, which friend are you choosing? Teacher. Precious, eh? Okay, so Precious, you have got a friend.
Yeah.
Precious, you have got
excuse
a friend.
Excuse me, teacher.
There.
Teacher.
Yes.
I might not be the only precious.
Excuse me, teacher.
You are the one we are seeing.
Excuse
Linda.
Me, teacher.
Yes, Agatha.
Teacher.
Okay.
Teacher, what is meant by using a dot? Teacher.
Someone has not tried Agatha, to. Somebody has not put her name.
Using their real names. So
they didn't put their name. So you have to use your username.
Okay.
Okay, so we have seen the work. Farid, are you on the WhatsApp group?
Yeah.
Okay, so they are going to put that work there. They have, I think somebody has screenshot the work and is going to put it there for you people. Okay. You look at those questions and you do the needful. Nuriat, yes, your hand has been up for long.
So how do we handle
in.
How do you hand in? You don't know how to hand in on the Google platform.
From where? Like you haven't.
Let me. I'm going to tell Mr. Namda. I'm going to tell Mr. Namda to show to send to you the video of how you hand in your work.
No,
in the Google Classroom.
As in where?
You have not put the assignments there.
The assignments.
Like the place where we're going to
put. This is the assignment. I'll just put it there. Don't worry.
Teacher, what of us are not who don't have the passwords? As for who are on the Google Classroom. Yeah.
You have to do it, yeah?
Teacher,
why put it on the platform?
Teacher, from my
classroom specifically for this thing to be the
Aliyah, what is it?
Yes? No, teacher, I was saying you didn't put where we're going to hand it from. Like the place where we're
The Nabisunsa e-learning platform, not Google Classroom. Nabisunsa e-learning platform. Those people who are not Nabisunsa students, you have to inbox Mr. Namdala. I create for you the Google Classroom where you are going to submit your work.
And
excuse me now. Where can we get Mr. Namdala's number?
On WhatsApp.
In the WhatsApp group.
Yes.
Abdurrahman, you can talk to Mr. Sendaula to give you Mr. Namdala.